Hi everyone, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm R. Santhya, Assistant Professor, Department of Food Processing and Preservation Technology, Faculty of Engineering, Avinashlingam University for Women, Coimbatore. Introduction. Food preservation aims at preventing the microbial spoilage of food products and the growth of foodborne pathogens. Thus, the two principal goals of food preservation methods are increasing the shelf life of the food and ensuring the safety for human consumption. Heat preservation is a method that uses heat to kill the microorganism or to suppress their growth and to inactivate the enzymes. Heat kills microorganism by changing the physical and chemical properties of their proteins. There are various degrees of preservation by such as sterilization, pasteurization, canning and blanching. Blanching is an important unit operation in food processing and done as pre-treatment before freezing, canning or drying. It is also known as scalding, parboiling and pre-cooking. This technique is done for the purpose of inactivation of enzymes, modification of texture, removal of trapped air and preservation of color, flavor and nutritional value. Fruits are generally not blanched, leaving the oxidizing enzyme system active. Sometimes fruit is plunged for a given time, say 5 minutes, according to variety, into water at 180 degree to 200 degree Celsius and then immediately cool by immersion in cold water. The object is to soften the texture and so enable a greater weight to the pressed into the container without damage to the individual fruit. Blanching is usually done in case of vegetables by exposing them to boiling water or steam for 2 to 5 minutes followed by cooling. The extent of blanching varies with the food products. Sensory evaluation of foods. After going through this session, you will be able to understand the sensory organs and its attributes, the functions of sensory assessment, the difference test and the objective evaluation. Next, the criteria and methods for food evaluation. The food evaluation is broadly classified into two types, sensory and objective method. Under sensory, we are going to see about color, flavor, taste, mouthfeel, size, shape, transparency, glossiness. Under objective, we are going to see about color, flow, elasticity, texture, diameter, thickness, clarity, and viscosity. All this are grouped under one term known as acceptability. First one is subjective evaluation. Subjective methods are methods of evaluating food quality using our sensory organs that functions to detect our color, taste, flavor, and so on. These methods are also called sensory methods. Thus, subjective evaluation is highly dependent on the sensitivities of the people and other factors such as pH, temperature, and so on. Next, sensory organs and its attributes. The sensory organ consisting of eyes, nose, ears, mucous membranes of the mouth, tongue, and skin are the organs of touch respond to the sensation of sight, smell, taste, feel, and sound of food. First one is sight. The appearance is an important factor in deciding whether the food will be tasted or not. Appearance covers color, shape of the portion, transparency, brightness, and so on. The next is flavor. It is a complex sensation obtained from volatile food components such as hydrocarbons, alcohol, aldehydes, ketones, esters, amines, furans, and pyrazines. Fat and fat-soluble substances have also been shown to be involved in flavor differences, especially in meats from different species. This consists of three distinct components: smell or odor, taste and mouthfeel. Next is odor. This plays an important role in food acceptability as it stimulates appetite even before the appearance of the food. Odors from the food are important indices of freshness and even wholesomeness of food. The odor constitutes of foods are strongly preserved by tasting rather than by smelling alone. Taste. Taste is a deciding index for food likes and dislikes. The organs responsible for taste are the taste buds. Most of the taste sensation are felt along those sides and back of the tongue connected to the food pipe. There are four recognized tastes that the taste buds can pick up, such as sweet, salt, sour, and bitter. Taste buds near the tip of the tongue detect sweet and salt sensation, while those on the sides are sensitive to sourness, and the rear ones pick up the bitter taste in foods. Next, mouthfeel. It is related to the feel food in the mouth, which strongly influences acceptability. Nerve fibers from the trigeminal nerve are responsible for this sensation. Texture. It is defined as an attribute of a substance resulting from a combination of physical properties and perceived by the senses of touch, sight, and hearing. The physical properties include size, shape, number, nature, and conformation of structural elements. Mechanical characteristics, which relates to the reaction of foods to stress, such as hardness, bitterness, gumminess, chewiness, elasticity, and cohesion. Next is a geometric characteristics. It relates to the size, shape, particle orientation like grain, grid, fibers, and so on. Next is a moisture characteristics. It relates to the moisture and the fat perceptions, such as juiciness, greasiness, and oiliness resulting from moisture and fat released during mastication. Teeth plays an important role in the perception of texture while biting, chewing, and swallowing. Visual appearance and touch through food manipulation provide some idea of firmness, fibrousness, crispiness, moldability through cut and knife penetration. Next, sound. The sound accompanying breaking of food, either by hand or while eating, is perceived as crisp, short, heavy, or light, depending on the characteristics of the product being judged. Sound is an important indicator of quality for short crust products such as biscuit, cookies, crackers, and the likes, and the reflect texture as well. The overall palatability is not strictly a sensory attribute. It is important for determining the acceptability of the food. Palatability represents the cumulative perception or impression left on the evaluator of the food. Next is the sensory assessment. Judging the food quality is a matter of panelist reaction to the sensory qualities of the food. The assessment is affected by a number of psychological and social factors. Scientific methods of sensory assessment of food quality are becoming increasingly important. The practical requirements for conducting any sensory assessment involve the following attributes: food science laboratory, experimental design, taste panels, sample preparation, assessment technique, and finally the product analysis. Sensory evaluation laboratory. A reception area or room is a sensory evaluation is essential for evaluating the foods. The testing booth should be arranged with the product neatly, placed with a plate and a spoon or fork. The evaluation form and a pen and a clear glass of water should be kept. Next is the experimental design. The steps to be involved are the objective of the evaluation, the standardization of the food product, and selection of food attributes to be assessed. Selection, agreement, and communication with the panelist. Fixing date of evaluation, preparing the scorecard with instruction for the completion, preparation of samples and pre-testing to make modification in score sheets, setting up the taste booths, preparing and laying out samples properly coded, ensuring neatness and silence in the environment, receiving panelists, briefing them verbally and in writing regarding procedures, timing, and so on, supervising the evaluation, deciding on the statistical test to be used, collecting data, and final analysis. The next is taste panel. A taste panel consists of people who are requested to assess the food quality of samples presented for evaluation. The panel members should have a certain qualities which are briefly listed. They possess good food standards and experience with the foods. they should be exposed to a large variety of foods. They should have a strong likes or dislikes for any foods. They should be highly sensitive to small changes in odor, taste, flavor, and other characteristics of foods. They have a knowledge of quality characteristics and cooking methods for foods being evaluated. They should be non-smokers and non-drinkers. They should be in good health condition. They should be literate and have a good memory for flavors to make comparisons. Certain rules need to be followed if sensory evaluation is to give reliable results. They are: the panelists should not be ill or affected by any other infection at the time of judging. They should not be very hungry while tasting the samples. The next is sample preparation. Samples should be prepared as close to the evaluation time as possible to prevent any changes in their quality. The sample should be prepared in the same lot under standardized laboratory conditions. Accurate weights and measures of ingredients and temperature and time controls in the procedures are essential for reproducibility of the samples. A master sheet should be prepared to the panelist. Next, assessment techniques. It includes a preference test. First one is preference test. It involves a large number of individuals representing the product to be launched. It is conducted in the marketplace by a group of company representatives. This process is continued for 7 to 10 days in different markets and the results are analyzed statistically. The next is difference test. This testing technique is also called discrimination testing. There are four methods of test under this. First one is paired test, rating test, triangle test, duo trio test, and sorting test. Paired test, the panelists involved may vary from 5 to 12 if trained and 70 to 80 if untrained. The two paired comparison tests are two alternative forced choice test, difference paired comparison test. The below table shows a design for sample preparation in the paired test. This is the triangle test evaluation scorecard. This is a format for your trio test. This is a format for differences in food samples by your trio test method. The sorting test, in this the panelists receive 5 samples and are required to sort them out in 2 groups. One with 2 samples that are different from the remaining 3 in the second group. This technique works well when one visual or a tactile comparison are required. The next is rating technique. When more than 3 samples need to be evaluated and accuracy is desired, then a scorecard developed with all the attributes of the sample is developed and marked with the relevant score against the attribute as indicated in the below table. The below table shows the evaluating of multiple food samples. Numeric scorecard test requires a card to be designed for scoring purpose on which a maximum score for a quality of the product is 100. The table shows the sample score sheet for numeric scoring. Hedonic test is a test that focuses on general acceptability in which the panelists record their likes and dislikes on a 5 to 10 point descriptor scale. This table shows the hedonic scale for the food evaluation. The composite score test is useful for grading batches of same product and for detecting the defect in the production of a particular batch. The descriptive analysis is usually used on a single sample for the purpose of a detailed analysis of perceived sensory attributes. This is a very sophisticated tool used for sensory evaluation of each attribute. The next is objective evaluation. Objective method of food evaluation depend heavily on instruments to measure the characteristics of different food. There are 3 basic approach to objective assessment. First one is measurement using calibrated instruments, microscopic examination of structures, determination of the chemical composition of foods. First one is measurement. There are large varieties of instruments from the very simple to complex have been designed for accuracy of measuring each attribute. First one is weighing balance. Balances of different types, sizes and accuracies are available, which can be used in a laboratory. Volumetric equipments. Different type of glassware are used to measure the volume of liquids, reagents and fluids. This enables the experimenter to measure its equivalence in metric or any other measurement system. A knowledge of the weight or volume of substance dissolved in a liquid or solvent helps to establish its concentration in the final product. The next is thermometers. These are used for measuring the temperature of foods during cooking and processing because the texture and the doneness of the product is largely dependent on the temperature. Temperature scales may be calibrated in Celsius or as in Fahrenheit. There are different types of thermometer. Under that, first one is room thermometer. This thermometer range varies from 18 degree to 22 degree Celsius. The two metal thermometer is constructed using two type of metals. With rise and fall of temperature, the two metals expand or contract, moving the pointer on the scale. Next one is maximum and minimum thermometer. This is usually used to record the lowest and highest temperatures during storage. The next is cold storage or refrigeration thermometer. They are constructed with red colored ethanol for easy reading in the presence of the cold mist. The range of temperature from minus 30 degree to minus 100 degree Celsius. The next is sugar thermometer. This thermometer ranges from 10 degree to 230 degree Celsius. The next is oven thermometer. The temperature changes from 10 degree to 370 degree Celsius. It is suitable for baking, grilling and roasting of foods. Dow testing thermometer. The temperature ranges from 10 degree to 43 degree Celsius. The next one is meat thermometer. The device is usually used for recording the internal temperature of large pieces of meat to know if they are cooked thorough, as in roast lamb. The next one is hygrometers. These are simple instruments which helps to measure the relative density of liquid foods. It has a weighted bulb and a graduated scale on the stem. The instruments are allowed to float in the liquid and the depth to which it sinks is read on the stem. The next one is color measurement. The color perception is inaccurate by sensory method. Therefore, objective methods make use of instruments which are based on the principle of color matching. First one is photoelectric instrument. These devices are fitted with photoelectric cells which take over eye function of the human retina. The next one is spectrophotometer. In these instruments, a curve relating to the wavelength and color intensity makes it possible to calculate a complete physical specification of color. The next is texture. Instruments have been devised to measure the rheological characteristics of foods. Every texture measuring device has some parts such as driving mechanism, probe element, force directing element, sensing and recording system. The next one is texturometers. These devices are based on empirical methods. Some of them are discussed below. First one is shotometer. It measures the force to break a biscuit. Next one is penetrometer. These are used for determining the internal tenderness of large cuts of meat. The next is viscometers. These are used for measuring the concentration of syrups, viscosity and consistency of pulps, etc. The next one is gel meter. This measures the flow time of a pectin extract. The next is a Briggs refractometer. This is used to measure the concentration of sugar. Line spread test is used to measure the differences in the consistency of batters, etc. Compressimeter is an instrument used for measuring the firmness of or staleness of the bread. Havilograph measures the strength of the dough by blowing a sheet of dough into a bubble. Farinograph indicates the type of cereal from which the flour of dough is made and tests the dough with a gluten strands. Extensograph. It measures the stretchability of dough and records the stretch graphically. The pH meter is used for measuring the acidity or alkalinity through the measurement of hydrogen ion concentration of foods being tested. These devices measured from 0 to 14 pH. The next is imitative device. These are designed to stimulate the mastication and bite. The taste of the food product is properly assessed only by human sensory perception, and instruments can only analyze single component at a time. Let us sum up the whole thing. the main aim of food preservation is to reduce the microbial load in the food products, which will prevent it from spoilage. Sterilization and blanching are the two methods of food preservation. Sterilization decreases the microbial load of the food products using ultra-high temperature method. Blanching, which inactivated the various undesirable acids and enzymes using different methods of blanching, such as water blanching, steam blanching, etc.